ايوه
not a bad one.
Welcome back, guys. Today, guess what? We're doing another Temu challenge. Y'all showed a lot of interest in all the last Temu video I did. And all on YouTube, everybody's doing Temu, fishing stuff. So I actually had ordered some more stuff and it came in the other day and I forgot about it. So I'm about to show y'all what I got. I think you're gonna like it. Make sure you read everything on the fine print, you know, because you'll end up ordering something that's like super micro when you thought it was bigger, or you think you're getting the whole everything in the picture and you're not. So be careful when you're reading the description. But anyway, let me show you what I got. Done opened it up, so sorry. Couldn't wait to see what was in it, so I'm not gonna have the big orange package to show you. But I got this reel. It is a 3+1, so I guess it's 4 bearings. So, I mean, not many bearings, but it's cheap. It's like a 7.21 gear ratio, I believe. But it actually feels really good. It's, I don't have any. When you do like that, you know, it don't have a whole lot of play in it. So, that's good. Actually, I'm sorry, 6.3:1 is what it is. But we're gonna be using that today. Check out the scale. Cheap scale. The hook folds. I mean, snaps in the back like that. Boom. Called Skeep. I don't know, never heard of it. But if you're like me, this is Skeep and I'm cheap, then I recommend buying some of this Temu stuff, because if you, I don't know if you looked at the prices like at Academy lately, it's pretty expensive stuff. Don't know how accurate the scale is yet, but you know what? Maybe we get to use it today. Also got some braided line. And I think this was like $1.98 because I bought it. If you remember in the last video that I did, it was the same kind, but cheap braid. It's like 20 pounds, something like that. And I actually liked it, so I bought more. And I mean, you got to have some pliers. Got to have some pliers. Not a bad set of pliers. It's got a little locking mechanism right there. It's got a, you can clip your line right here. It's sharp. It's got grips on the end. I mean, just a not a bad set of pliers for cheap. Some people say, I'm not ordering from China. Buying the USA. Yeah, I'm all for buying in the USA. Don't get me wrong. But if you look at most stuff you buy, I guarantee you most of your stuff you got is from China. So. And this is like some type of whopper plopper I got. I mean, it looks really good. The hooks are real sharp. I think that's gonna be a good bait to use. Like I said, I mean, these baits, if you go to Walmart, if you go to Academy, I mean, you're gonna spend $8 on something like that. And if it catches fish, who cares if it's not a brand name? Some folks are all about the brands. I'm not. I just wanna catch fish. So, now, oops, cut this. I haven't even opened this one yet, but it's like a little, kind of a little jerkbait maybe. And I really like the colors on it. I mean, it shimmers, got black on the top, a little bit of red on the bottom. I think that right there is gonna be excellent. I got these. And this is not really for me because I'll grab the fish, but my daughter fishes with me a lot, so. And she's not scared of them most of the time.
All right, let it go. Mine's flopping.
Good job. All right, go throw them in the water. Good job. You did it all by yourself? So sometimes she is, if it's a little bit bigger of a fish, This was cheap, so that way she can grab the fish and not worry about it flipping, flopping, scratching her thumb. You know the deal. You know how little girls are. Then I got this bait. It almost looks like, if you're familiar with like the DT series or Palamakes, it's kind of the same shape and almost the same bill. But I really like the way it looked. You can see it. But I can't wait to try this one. So we're about to spool up and hurry up and get out here. It's already about 8 o'clock. So a little bit late, but had things I had to do. So hopefully we can still catch fish. So let's just go ahead and spool up with this. And today we're gonna take the kayak out. That's what we're gonna do. We're gonna fish in the kayak. It's gonna be a challenge, but I like a challenge. So let's just go ahead and spool up real quick. Boom. All right, now we're ready to start fishing. First bait of choice is gonna have to be the whopper plopper looking deal. Put that through there. And we are gonna put white on white. Let's put on this ducket rod that I got. It didn't have a reel on it. Boom, look at that. Let's give it a dangle. That's different hand head. Dang it. Ooh. Oh, we gotta move that seat way up.
Go. Don't mind my legs too much.
Oh,
one thing I forgot to mention. Silly me.
The fake coasters from Temu. Check that out. Fake coasters. Boasters. Or fakesters. I like fakesters.
That, man, I forgot to mention. I can't believe that. Dang. First cast on the reel. Wow, like that. I just know I'm gonna knock that GoPro off, I'm gonna tell you. First cast, Temu reel. I didn't even set my brace. And throwing the whopper plopper. Better do that. Get it set. There we go. Not bad. I like the action on it. Really like this action. It's kind of heavy in the bottom. Kind of sits, you know, straight up. I don't know if I like that. I'm not a big kayaker. I go out and kayak occasionally, but is there any way you can do it and not get wet? Like, I turn my paddles like this because it seems like the water doesn't come off of it, bring down the paddle near as much. I don't know. Pure kayaker. Give me some advice. Or is that just something like you have to deal with? What I need to do, I'm gonna paddle over to the other side. It's still in the shade. So let's just go ahead and do that. Those fish might still be hitting top. Yeah, much better. Much better. First, I'm calling first cast over here to shade. We'll catch one.
There he is. Oh, on the stump.
Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Little guy, but he counts. First fish on the Temu.
Flyers, I'm almost forgot.
Catch one big enough, I'm gonna weigh them. All right, so.
Not a bad little fish. Little bitty guy. Not bad. Thanks for playing.
All right, let's get another one. So that didn't take long. Once I came over here, got in the shade, got one. See if we can't get another one, and then we're gonna switch up for the same bait.
I don't know if you've ever fished out a kayak, but it's a little more difficult to kind of work your bait. Like I said, I mean, I kayak, I take it to the river, I go different places, but I'm not an expert on all things kayak. I wasn't ready for that one. Oh, he is flying.
Good. Is he a bigger one?
I wasn't ready for him at all.
Hammered that. My GoPros had a problem with GoPros. I just caught another fish on the Whopper Plopper. Both of them cut off probably about the same time. I don't know. They'll get too hot when I'm recording on the highest quality setting. They get too hot. So if anybody can help me out with that issue, let me know. Why does it do that? I mean, what can you do to prevent it? If anything.
I started having problems with my GoPro, so I missed a lot of lost a lot of footage. But at this point, I'm fishing with the crankbait.
There he is. Oh my goodness. Little bitty one. I'm ashamed to even show you. Oh, but he counts. These are the ones that are hooky. Fat. He's fat. Fat and healthy. So, I mean, look at that. Look at that little gut. Good grief. All right, buddy. Thank you. I already caught one on this one. No need to keep fishing it. And we had like two more to get off. And that was mostly blame myself on that one. So now we're gonna put on a little shimmering jerkbait. Okay, yeah, this is the suspending. Little trick, when it gets like that, when it's hanging, gets hooked on the hooks, just kind of tap your handle, be like that. There you go. See, little trick, instead of having to reach over there and grab it. So we're gonna kind of, I think, just kind of twitch this one.
There you go.
My snoops. That's my favorite pair. Not a bad fish, though. Not a bad fish at all. Thanks for playing.
That's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed looking at my thighs. lost my favorite pair of snips. But that's okay. Hey, we caught a few fish. I showed you, hey, I was only out here 45 minutes or so, and I caught a fish on every lure that I got from Timu. Forgot to weigh that when I test out the scales. But we'll test that out in another video. I know they come on. That's all I know about them. Oh, I got the nice fakesters. So yeah, I mean, if you want to buy some good cheap bait that actually works and catch fish on, I recommend checking out Timu. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one. Peace.